Physical reality of the loss and the grief and the respect and the joy of these people became too close. It overwhelmed me. And I spent the next few days as we were setting up the display and opening the display and staffing it, feeling extremely grief-stricken and overcome. And after 3 or 4 or 5 days of being closely entwined with this exhibit on the display, I finally reached a point where I can truly concentrate on the love and the respect, the celebration of these people's lives. Almost every one of the panels is my favorite panel. I'm sure that would be the case if I saw every. But one panel that especially touches me, more so than the ones commemorating the children or the ones commemorating those who died alone or those made by mothers or, you know, for whatever reason, was a panel created in the memory of Danny Bird, who was approximately my age when he died. There's no tremendous focus on the loss or the unreached potential, but instead it really clearly demonstrates that this man had a wicked sense of humor.
executive director of the state.
Virginia Price and Virginia, you started reading down. Why don't you read down the first column and I'll read the second column? When you get done, bishop will say, Ryan Spellman, and I will start reading. If you haven't checked in now, check in immediately after we get done reading.
Okay.
I think that will be okay at this point. I don't know that we have time for you to check in now.
Please, cheers. Pardon?
Thank you. Jesse Wilbur, Billy Powers, and my Montana friend, Sometimes I feel like I'm empowered, but I'm frustrated because it's like feeling overwhelmed by all of it and wanting to do more than I feel like I can do as an individual and being frustrated with that. Some of the panels I read, I cannot believe how young everybody is. That's another one. That's one that really gets me though. And this, the big 4x4 thing they have on the names project with all the signatures and things on it, sometimes that gets to me more than the panels, because I think a lot of people that ended up signing that, they don't know anybody who's died of AIDS, but it's like the quilt really provoked a lot of things they'd never thought of about before. Being here opening night was incredible, because all the high school kids that were here for the youth conference were down on the quilt, and I would say a good 70% of them were in tears. And it was just dead silent. It was probably one of the most powerful emotional experiences I've ever had.
It was was a real experience to come face to face with panels that were made in memory of people whom I had known who lived in Missoula at one time. One of those panels was in memory of David Eggenweiler, who is one of the principal players, developers, originators of out in Montana, who developed a newsletter, a statewide gay and lesbian newsletter. A wonderful human being, a tremendous young man. And I knew his lovers, Rich and Christopher. Well, I knew Rich, I didn't know Christopher, but wonderful person. Lived in Missoula many years, contributed a lot to our community, and we do miss him.
Get the cameras over here.
All right. There are three basic tasks
that have to be done before we leave this building. The first one is the quilt has to be folded. And that requires, the quilt has to be, take your shoes off. The quilt has to be folded. I will show you how to do that in just a minute. The walkways will have to be rolled, and the merchandise will have to be packed. In addition, I will need, do we have any host committee members here? Dan? You're already signed up. Okay, you two will need to go over to the money changing area. Dan, can you put your shoes back on? You two go over to money.
No hugging, no bare feet.
That's right, you guys go over to the money changing area to count money. The rest of you, folding panels is really important at this time that it be done correctly. The first thing, and I've got Marion and Nisha are out there cutting, because we only have two sets of cutters. We're getting cheap in our old age. Once this panel's unfolded, what you do is you go from the top, and there's always a top to a panel, and you fold it down all the way. Sort of fluff it to make sure that it's even. Fold it down again. And then you're gonna fold it in quarters. One quarter, two quarters, three quarters. And we used to have to tell you left to right and up and down, it's crazy. But we've got them on all the quarters now, so just make sure a number is showing. That's essential for both panel checkout from here and panel check-in when they arrive back in San Francisco. Those numbers are how we keep track of the quilt.
Which is
59, 12 by 12s? So, yeah, 59, 12 by 12s. So once you've folded a 12 by 12, it's gotta go in one of the 11 boxes. Now any of you that are as good at math as I am will figure out that's a little more than 5 to a box, okay?
Everybody's gonna have that principle.
Thank you.